At my last doctor's appointment, in the waiting room, I found myself sitting opposite a rather confident 7-year-old. To pass time while her mother was inside, she decided to talk to me. "So, what do you do?" she asked. "I write," I said with a smile. "Oh, my new daddy writes." Curious, I took the bait. "New daddy? Well, my daddy's a lawyer, my mummy married again, and my new daddy, he's a writer." "That's interesting," I commented. As if to reassure me, she added, "I like both of them." Before I could get to know more about this self-assured child, her mother came out and she left. Today, as divorce rates rise, it's good to see children like the little girl I met. Children who have clearly coped with huge changes in their life. No child wants her parents to separate. So it is important to be as clear as possible. Give the children a real reason for the divorce. Pick something simple yet honest, like "we do not get along anymore." And most important, they need to know it is not their fault.
Gordon, can I tell you something?
Oh, sure, Abby.
Well, you know my mommy and daddy are getting a divorce, right?
Yeah, I know.
Well, I'm really worried that maybe it's because of me.
What? No.
No, because, yeah, sometimes I don't clean my room. And this one time, I turned my mommy's favorite vase into a pumpkin.
No, Abby, and then... Abby, listen to me. It is not your fault. A divorce happens because of problems between grown-ups. It is never a child's fault.
Are you sure?
Yes. You didn't make this happen.
That makes me feel a little better.
Good.
But still, I wish there was something I could do to stop the divorce, Gordon. Yeah. Like, maybe I could do a magic spell, or
Abby, huh? Not even magic can change something like this. I mean, you can't fix it, and you can't wish it away.
A child goes through so many emotions when her family breaks up. Fear, sadness, anger, worry that it is their fault. Torn, because they feel that they have to take sides. So understand how difficult it is for the child and encourage them to keep talking through the process. Help them name and understand their feelings.
Well, whenever you're going through a big change like a divorce, mm-hmm. it's important to talk to someone about what you're thinking or feeling.
Yeah, made me feel a whole lot better.
So, you don't feel sad about the divorce anymore?
Not as much as I used to. But back then, I thought I'd be mad and sad forever.
But things have gotten easier?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it took a while, but I've got used to the changes now.
What changes, like living in two different houses?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and seeing my mommy some days and my daddy some days.
But I bet there are some things that stay the same, too, right?
Oh, sure. Well, I still get to see the people I love, like my grandparents.
That's good.
Yeah, and I still sleep every night with my stuffed frog prince. Only I have two beds, one at my mommy's and one at my daddy's. But I always have somebody I love to tuck me in at night.
Just like every family, every divorce is different, and every kid reacts differently to divorce. So communicate that in the midst of all this change, some things just don't change. For one, you will always be their parent, and nothing can change that. Explain the parts of their routine which will remain. They will go to school, to nanny's house for art class. And most importantly, tell your children that you will always be there for them. With the right support, they will emerge as strong, sensitive individuals.